Student, how do you do?
Yes, I'm fine.
I was fine. Okay, dear student, there are many famous people in our country. They are famous for their respective duties. They are famous for their respective domain. They are famous for their respective works. Okay. And do you know this type of people who are famous for their activities, for their domain? Do you know in our country, please?
Qazi Nazrul Islam
is famous and he has achieved perfection for literature. Okay. And he has set an epochal example in the arena of literature. And also Michael Madhusudan also achieved success in literature. And also another people in our country who have become famous for their activities.
Sir Abbasuddin.
Abbasuddin is famous for folk song. Abbasuddin is famous for folk song. If there any other man, they are famous for their respective duties. Do you know?
Jagadish Chandra Bosu.
Jagadish Chandra Bosu. He is famous for as a scientist. He is famous as a scientist. Suppose I would like to show the picture. Please you to come here. This is the picture of Michael Madhusudan. Okay.
Yes.
This is the picture of Michael Madhusudan. He is famous for his literature. He is famous for literature. Okay. There are also another picture here. Abbasuddin. He is famous for Abbasuddin Ahmed. He is famous for folk song. He is famous for folk song. In this way, there are many people in the world. There are many people in the world who have become famous for their own duties, for their respective sphere, for their respective domain. Do you know in the world there are many famous people in the world? Do you know? Please mention one of the name.
Newton.
Sir Isaac Newton. He is famous for. He is famous as a scientist.
Yes.
Do you know any other name in the world?
George Washington.
He is also famous for politician, as a leader. Then any other name in literature? There is a name in literature. Rabindranath Tagore. Rabindranath Tagore also famous for literature. Okay. Haji Muhammad Mohsin, he is also famous for
mankind.
So I would like to some picture here. There are another picture, Kaikobad. Okay. Kaikobad. He is also famous for
literature.
He is also famous for literature. Okay. Then Rabindranath Tagore. Rabindranath Tagore, he is also famous for Rabindranath Tagore. He is also famous for literature. Okay. He is also famous for literature. Here, there are another picture here. Ishwarchandra Vidyasagar. He is also famous for
literature.
Bengali literature. There is another picture here. There are seven oil heroes in our country. They are famous for because they sacrifice their life for the sake of the country. There is another famous picture here. She is Begum Rokeya Shakadoshan, okay? She is Begum Rokeya Shakadoshan. She is the embodiment. She is famous. She is famous for awakening women. She is famous for awakening women. So she is also famous. There is another picture, Supiya Kamal. He is also famous for literature. So there are many people in the world. Please come over here. Take your seat. There are many people in our country, in the world. There are many people in the world. They are famous for their respective duties. Like Isaac Newton as a scientist. Then Einstein as a scientist. And in the medical science, there are many renowned people in the world. Do you know?
Yes, sir.
Please mention one of the names.
Ibn Sina.
Ibn Sina is famous for medical science, okay?
Yes, sir.
And in the world, there are some people who is famous for the welfare of mankind.
Yes, sir.
In the world, there are some people who are famous for the welfare of mankind. They sacrifice their life. They have become famous for the welfare of mankind, for the well-being of mankind. Can you mention some of the name?
Yes, sir.
Suppose Haji Muhammad Mohsin, yes. Swami Vivekananda, okay?
Yes,
Swami Vivekananda. I would like to show the picture of Swami Vivekananda also. Please, if you come here, please. Swami Vivekananda. He is famous for mankind, okay?
Yes, sir.
He is famous for mankind. He is a divine man, okay? He is a divine man, and he is the he has become and he has achieved success in the arena of spiritual world, okay? He has become successful in the spiritual world because he is a divine man. And he is also performed many duties for the welfare of mankind. Okay? There are many people in the world who are famous for the welfare of mankind, like Haji Muhammad Mohsin, then Helen Keller, many people. But there are few women in the world who sacrifice their life for mankind. Do you mention one of the name of this type of woman? Please mention.
Mother Teresa, Florence Nightingale, Helen Keller.
Helen Keller. They are famous for the welfare of mankind, and they sacrifice their life for the welfare of mankind. And they dedicate themselves for the welfare of mankind. So, Mother Teresa is this type of man who is famous for the welfare of mankind. So today I am talking about Mother Teresa, okay? I am talking about Mother Teresa. Mother Teresa. Dear students, please open your book, Unit 12, Lesson 2. Unit 12. Lesson 2. Unit 12, Lesson 2. Actually, I would like to show. Please, you to come here. Actually, this is the picture of Mother Teresa, okay? This is the picture of
Mother Teresa.
Okay. And there are many lines in her face. Because he works hard. She works hard. And she's an old woman. So there are many lines in her face. And she put on the dress. If we focus our attention on the dress, we can visualize that. Actually, she is a nun, okay? She is a nun. Because Her dress is as like as none. Okay. Then there are another picture of Mother Teresa. Okay. There are another picture, please. There are another picture of Mother Teresa. Here is another picture of Mother Teresa. And I think she is talking with, do you know this woman? Do you know this woman? Here. She is Princess Diana. Princess Diana. She is a woman of England. Princess? Diana. And Mother Teresa is talking with?
Diana.
Princess Diana, okay? Come here. Here, there are many pictures here. Mother Teresa is with the father of Christian community. Here, Mother Teresa loves a child. Mother Teresa also loves a child. Here is also a picture of Mother Teresa, okay? Please go to your seat. So, actually, you have already known about Mother Teresa, okay? So, dear students, please look at section A. There are many pictures. Please look at the picture. And talk about the picture in English with your partner, okay? With your partner. Into the partner. Please talk about the picture. Time is finished. So who can tell about the picture? Please raise up your hand. Okay, you. What do you see in the first picture?
In the picture one, I saw a man is carrying a patient on a stretcher.
Very good.
I saw it is the operation theater, a doctor and a patient interact into it.
Okay. What do you see in the third picture?
In the third picture, I saw a doctor is looking after a patient.
What do you see in the picture number four?
In the fourth picture, I saw a syringe.
In the picture number five?
In the picture five, I saw a nurse is taking care of a patient.
A nurse is taking care of a patient. Okay. Thank you very much. Okay. So, what do you see in the picture? What do you see in the first picture?
In the first picture, a man carrying a patient on the stretcher.
This is
the.
Then, what do you see in the second picture?
In the second picture, I saw it was the operation theater and a man and a patient enter into it.
Not I saw, but I see. Because now you are seeing, So, in the second picture, you see that there is an operation theater. And actually, a doctor is doing something in the operation theater. So what do you see in the picture of third picture? What do you see in the third picture?
In the third picture, I see a doctor is looking after a patient.
What do you see in the picture number four?
In the fourth picture, I see a syringe.
And picture number five?
In the fifth picture, I see a nurse is taking care of a patient.
Okay, thank you very much. Please sit down. So now, I would like to ask you some question. Anybody can answer the question. Have you ever been ill? Have you ever been ill? You?
Yes, sir.
When was it? When was it?
It was 2008.
2008,
yes.
Okay. What sort of illness was it? What sort of illness was it?
Typhoid.
Typhoid. How did you feel at that time? How did you feel at that time?
Very upset.
Very upset. You feel very nervous.
Yes.
Do you feel any pain? Do you feel any pain in your body?
Sometimes.
Yes. So who looked after you?
My mother.
Your mother. Beside medicine, what else do you need in time of illness? Beside medicine, what type of things do you need in time of illness?
Besides medicine, somebody take care.
Somebody took care of you. Took care of you. Please sit down. Then anybody? Have you ever been ill?
Yes, sir.
You ever been ill? Achha. When was it?
When I read in class 7.
When I read in class 7. What sort of illness was it?
It's a fever.
Fever. Okay. How did you feel at that time?
Very sad and nervous. I feel all time tired.
Tired. And you also felt pain. You also felt pain. Who looked after you? Who looked after you?
My mother and my sister.
Okay. Beside medicine, what else do you need in time of illness?
Beside medicines, I need somebody's take care.
Somebody's take care, somebody's help, okay. So, dear students, please look at section B. Look at section B. Please look at the picture. In section B, there is a picture, okay? In section B, there is a picture. It is a picture of Mother Teresa, okay? Because you have already known about Mother Teresa. This is a picture of Mother Teresa. So, please look at the picture. She is a Mother Teresa. Please look at the picture and describe the picture, okay? You will take 3 minutes, okay? You will take 3 minutes. And talk about the picture with your partner, okay? Please sit down. Talk about the picture with your partner. I've already made a partner. So please talk about the picture with your partner. You will take 3 minutes. So who can tell about the picture? I would like to ask you some question about the picture. Please describe the person. Who can describe the person? Please raise up your hand. First you, please describe the person.
Mother Teresa. She sacrificed her life welfare of mankind.
Sacrificed the welfare of mankind.
She is famous for his mankind, for the sacrifice.
She is famous for her mankind, for the welfare of mankind. She is famous for the welfare of
mankind.
And what is her profession? Actually,
she
is a nurse. She is a nurse. She served as a. What type of work does she do? She served the people. Okay. She served the dying, destitute. She served the sick man. She served the poor people. This type of thing. So she sacrificed her life. She sacrificed her life for the sake of the dying, destitute, and sick people. She sacrificed her life. She was devoted. She was devoted to the poor, dying, and destitute. So, where did she work? Do you know?
She worked in Kolkata.
She worked in Calcutta. She worked in Calcutta. Is she still alive?
No.
No. Please sit down. You. What is your profession? What is your profession? Do you know?
Her profession is mankind.
Actually. She served for the people. She served for the welfare of the people. She served for the welfare of the people. She dedicated her life for dying, destitute, and sick people. I would like to read out the text. Okay. And actually, please look at the passages. There are many gaps. Okay. There are many. Gaps. I actually read out the text and you listen to what I say. When I read out the text, you don't write down. After finishing my reading out, then you write down. Then you fill the gap. When I read out the topic, you just listen. Okay. Please sit down. Mother Teresa was moved by the presence of the sick and dying on the streets of Calcutta. She founded the home for the dying, destitute, and named it Nirmal Hridaya, meaning pure heart. She and her fellow nuns gathered dying people of the streets of Calcutta and brought them to this home to care for them during the days before they died. Ever since then, more than 42,000 of men, women, and children have been taken from the streets and transported to Nirmal Hridaya. Approximately 19,000 of those had the opportunity to die in an environment of kindness and love. In their last hours, they met human and divine love and could feel that they also are children of God. Those who survived, the missionaries of charity tried to find jobs or they were sent to homes where they could live happily some more years in a caring environment. Regarding commitment to family, Mother Teresa said, maybe in our own family we have somebody who is feeling lonely, who is feeling sick, who is feeling worried. Are we there? Are you willing to give until it hurts in order to be with our families? Or to do we put our interest first? We must remember that love begins at home. And we must also remember that future of humanity passes through the family. So could you understand? Can you write down the gap? So I again read out the topic. You listen to. Okay? You see the gap and listen to what I say. Don't write down, okay? Please listen to. Again, Mother Teresa was moved by the presence of the sick and dying on the streets of Calcutta. She founded the home for the dying destitute and named it Nirmal Hridaya, meaning pure heart. She and her fellow nuns gathered dying people of the streets of Calcutta and brought them to this home to care for them during the days before they died. Ever since then, more than 40,000 of men, women and children have been taken from the streets and transported to Nirmal Hridaya. Approximately 19,000 of those had the opportunity to die in an environment of kindness and love. In their last hours, they met human and divine love and could feel that they also are children of God. Those who survived the missionary society tried to find jobs, or they were sent to homes where they could live happily some more years in a caring environment. Regarding commitment to family, Mother Teresa said, maybe in your own family we have somebody who is feeling lonely, who is feeling sick, who is feeling worried. Are you there? Are you willing to give until it hurts in order to be with our families? Or do we put our interest first? We must remember that love begins at home. And we must also remember that future of humanity passes through the family. Okay? So have you understood? Can you feel the gap? Can you feel the gap? Please try to feel the gap, okay? Please try to feel the gap. Okay. Please try to feel the gap. Everybody, let's try to feel the gap. Thank you. Please look at section C. Please look at section C. Everybody, please look at section C. Here are some information. Here are some statements. Here are some statements. Please read out the statement. Okay. First, read out the statement first. Okay. Read out the statements. It will take 2 minutes. Okay. Dear student, then there are many false and true statements. These statements are not true. There are many false and true statements. First you read out the statement, then I again read out the text, you listen to what I say, and then if it is false, write down F, if it is true, write down T. Sometimes if it is false, please write down the right information, okay? First you read the statement, then I listen to the topic, listen to the passage, then you write down true or false, okay? First you read out the statement, okay? The text, you listen to what I say, then try to guess the statement. If it is false, please write down F. If it is true, please write down T. If the information is correct, you should. If the information is wrong, you should write it in correct order. Okay. Now listen to what I say. Don't write down. Listen to what I say. Okay. Mother Teresa was moved by the presence of the sick and dying on the street of Calcutta. She founded the home for the dying destitute and named it Nirmal Hriday, meaning pure heart. She and her fellow nuns gathered dying people of the streets of Calcutta and brought them to this home to care for them during the days before they died. Ever since then, more than 42,000 of men, women and children have been taken from the streets and transported to Nirmal Hriday. Approximately 90,000 of those had the opportunity to die in an environment of kindness and love. In their last hours, they met human and divine love and could feel that they also are children of God. Those who survived, the missionaries of charity tried to find jobs, or they were sent to homes where they could live happily some more years in a caring environment. Regarding commitment to family, Mother Teresa said, "Maybe in our own family we have somebody who is feeling lonely, who is feeling sick, who is feeling worried. Are we there? Are we willing to give until it hurts in order to be with our families? Or do we put our interest first? We must remember that love begins at home. And we must also remember that future of humanity passes through the family." So now, read out the statement and write, if it is false, write down F, if it is true, write down 2, write down T, and if it is false, give the correct information, okay? Please write down. Section C. False and incorrect treatment, true and material. It's true or false? Professor was moved to see the epidemic that spread in the streets of Calcutta. If it is right or wrong?
True.
Mother Teresa was moved to see the epidemic that spread in the streets of Calcutta. Epidemic means spread as a spread in the haphazard way, eh? Epidemic. To spread in the haphazard way. To spread at a large number. To spread a large number. In your text, you have already learned that Mother Teresa was moved by the presence of the sick and dying on the streets of Calcutta. So, then next, she opened a home for both rich and poor people. False. Actually, she opened a home called Nirmal Vidar for the dying, destitute and sick people, not for the rich people, okay? Then, she and her companions would bring in the people who are dying in the streets.
Yes.
The false or right?
True.
True, okay. More than 42,000 old people were brought to Nirmal Vidar. If it is right or wrong? More than 42,000 old people were brought to Nirmal Vidar.
False.
In your text, ever since then, more than 42,000 of men, women and children have been taken from the streets and transported to Nirmal Vidar. So not only old people, but also men, women and children. So it is false. What is the correct answer? The correct answer is more than 42,000 of men, women and children. Okay. All to the home died.
False.
What is the correct answer?
Into the home died.
Approximately 19,000 of those had the opportunity to die in an environment of kindness and love. Okay. Mother Teresa brought the dying people to the home so that they could get an environment of hospital. Mother Teresa brought the dying people to the home so that they could get an environment of hospital. False. Okay. Then, in their last hours, the dying destitute met Mother Teresa and became children again. In their last hours, the dying destitute met Mother Teresa and became children again. If it is right or wrong? But in their last hours, they met human and divine love. They met human and divine love and could feel that they also are children of God. But not children again. So it is false. Okay?
Yes.
Then the last statement. The survived ones would get a job or home so that they could spend some years happily in a family, cared and looked after.
True.
Very good. True. Okay. Please sit down. So dear students, please look at section D. Everybody look at section D. It's information table. There are many information about Mother Teresa. Please read out the information and write down a paragraph about Mother Teresa, okay? Write down a paragraph about Mother Teresa, okay? And you will take only 10 minutes, okay? You will take... And read out your paragraph, okay? Please come here. Please come here and read out your paragraph.
Mother Teresa was born on 20...
Born. Mother Teresa was born.
27 August 1910. Her father's name was Albanian Builder. Her birthplace was Spokesy, Macedonia. She had two sisters and brother when at the age of 18 she joined the order of the Sisters of Our Lady of Loreto in
Ireland.
In 1928 she began her journey to India. In 1931 she began teaching at a Kolkata girls school. She founded Nirmal Hriday in 1952. She started an orphanage in...
In 1957,
she and missionaries of charity began working with lepers. She won Nobel Prize in 1979 and she died in 5 September 1997. So she is a famous woman in the world. We respect her very much.
Okay, thank you very much. Begin. Please go to your seat. Then who will come? Who will come and you have the paper? Please come here. Stand here. Read out the paragraph.
Mother Teresa was born on 27 August 1910. Her father's name was Albania Builder. Her birthplace was Isposa,
Macedonia.
She had a sister, brother, two older. She joined at the age of 18 the order of the Sister of Our Lady of Loreto. buried in Ireland. Her journey began at 1928 from India. Her teaching began at 1931 at Kolkata Girls School. She founded Nirmal Hriday. She started Queen's Nobel Prize at 1979. She died 7 September.
Okay, please go to your seat. Begin. Then who will come? Please come here. Please come here and mention your character. Please come here.
Mother Teresa. Mother Teresa was a mankind person. She was born in August 27 in 1910. Her father's name was Albanian Wilder. Her birthplace was Skopje, Macedonia. She had two sisters and a brother. When at the age of 18 joined the order of the Sisters of Our Lady of Loreto in Ireland. She began her journey of India in 1928. She began teaching at Kolkata Girls School in 1952, founded Nirmal Hriday, 1953, started an orphan 1957, she and her missionaries of charity began working with lepers. 1979, she wins a Nobel Prize. September 1979, she had died and we are respected her activity.
Okay, thank you very much, Dian. So then who will come? Who will come? Okay, actually we have about Mother Teresa.
Yes, sir.
So I again extend my thanks to each and every individual. Okay. I again extend my thanks, my greetings to each and every individual. Okay. See you again in the next class.